Welcome back to TenSlide Info. Even though Russia had been major aircraft provider for India until now, India has moved on to France to procure the Rafale Omnirole fighters. And I personally feel that that was a good decision by the Indian Air Force, since with more than 30,000 flight hours in operations, the Rafale fighter jet has proven its worth in combat even in Afghanistan, Libya, Iraq and Syria. In order to fill in the category of medium fighter, Russia is coming up with a brand new aircraft which is said to be having a maximum takeoff weight of 18 tons, which is very similar to India's Tejas Mark II or medium weight fighter. The Tejas Mark II is expected to have a maximum takeoff weight of 17.5 tons, which is similar to the upcoming Russian fighter. The company which is manufacturing this new fighter is Sukhoi, which is the manufacturer of Indian Air Force backbone fighter Sukhoi Su-30 MKI. If we dig into more details on this particular fighter, it is said that these new fighters would be powered using the same engine which was used for Sukhoi Su-57 multi-role 5th generation fighter, but it is said that this is going to be a single engine version. For any Air Force, single engine fighters are of lower maintenance costs and also considered optimal for any type of short range air defense and surface attack missions. Not only that, such single engine fighters also have a higher turnaround time. If we quickly compare the engine thrust of India's medium weight fighter, the engine which are going to power the Tejas Mark II are under 98 kN thrust, whereas the upcoming Sukhoi single engine fighter is powered using a 176 kN thrust engine. Even though the engine thrust has been on a stronger side for the Russian fighter, it looks like the internal weapons bay is going to be of smaller size, and we don't have a clear idea or details on the medium weight fighter's internal weapons bay. So in this parameter, we cannot decide which is on the stronger side. Coming to speed, the upcoming Russian single-engine tactical fighter is said to have a maximum speed of above Mach 2, and even the medium-weight fighter has the same Mach 2 as maximum speed. Next vital parameter, or the performance parameter, is the thrust-to-weight ratio. The medium-weight fighter of HAL is expected to have a thrust-to-weight ratio of 1, whereas it is said that the Russian fighter will have a thrust-to-weight ratio above 1. All these are documented things, and we need to wait and see what happens in reality. So what actually is the thrust to weight ratio? Thrust to weight ratio is the ratio of the aircraft's maximum thrust to its takeoff weight. A high thrust to weight ratio means an aircraft will have higher acceleration and rate of climb. An aircraft with thrust to weight ratio that is greater than 1 has a thrust greater than its weight, which means it can continue accelerating while climbing vertically. In addition to the engines which are coming from Sukhoi Su-57 fighter, it is said that these new fighters, which is said to be semi-stealthy, will be using the radio absorbing coatings, the onboard radio electronic equipment, a weapon system which would be very similar to Su-57. Even though these news are coming from the sources, we are not sure if everything will be taken care of when the final product comes out. So that was a very quick update and a small video which has encapsulated the vital details about the upcoming Russian single engine fighter, and we also did a very quick comparison between the medium weight fighter of HAL. Thanks for watching. I'll upload another video with a new defense update or an aviation update later. Please do subscribe my channel and hit the bell button next to it. And also feel free to leave a comment in the comment section. Thank you.